Well, it has officially happened. Sam's single 3D printer that he purchased a couple months ago has grown into 10 3D printers. What's up, guys? Sam here, and welcome back to Samcraft. That's right, when I started off with one 3D printer a couple months ago, I probably was in denial, thinking that that would be okay for a while, because now I have 10, and honestly, I'm looking to add more. In this video, I want to bring you guys along for a show and tell, a little bit of a story time, to show you how I have built and set up my miniature 3D print farm, but also want to talk to you about the printers I've chosen, why I chose them, where I get filament from, what kind of storage and organization solutions I've put into place, and just give you a little bit of how I built my print farm and that kind of info in this video. So, if that tickles your fancy, or you just want to hang out with me in the shop, stick around, because we're about to jump into it. The first thing to do is to take a trip down memory lane back whenever what you see behind me, which is my current 3D print farm, was nothing but shelves and stuff in the workshop. I put a video out of setting up my 3D print station, and that's where I reused a black metal wire shelf and turned it into a little DIY print station. That worked great. It is still in use just as a generic surface, but what I have since incorporated are large, heavy-duty metal shelving, commonly referred to as garage shelving. These are freestanding units. They have fully adjustable shelves, and they are robust and nice, big, chunky things to hold a bunch of 3D printers. What I needed was a place to store as many printers as possible within a square footage space of my workshop, but I wanted something that was a turnkey solution, something that was not a permanent build and a shelf that I attached to the wall or the floor that kind of locked me into this location and design long term. And I needed something that was honestly quick and easy to do. That led me down the road of picking up these metal shelves from Lowe's, but also places like Home Depot, Amazon, IKEA, a lot of other places sell these as well. Not long after getting the first shelf set up with the printers, I then ordered more printers and decided to make another shelf purchase, as well as a smaller shelf just to fill out the width of my workshop. This is a 20-foot wide workshop that I have, and I was already kind of chewing up a whole wall just for 3D printers, and decided to go ahead and put a 7-foot shelf, and the 3-foot in the middle to pretty much fill it out left to right and just give myself one giant wall of 3D print goodness. The large shelves are pretty self-explanatory. Their purpose in life is to hold 3D printers and a couple of storage totes or boxes down at the bottom. The shelf in the middle, I decided to turn into a small little workbench area of sorts to give myself a staging platform for tools and parts for 3D printers to live and stay in a place where I know where they are and they're accessible. The plywood top also can double as a workbench if I need to work on any 3D printer, pull it off of the shelf. I have a dedicated area that should stay mostly clean, so I could do that without too much trouble. But then the other third, and honestly most common use of this middle shelf, is as a staging point for what I call my stockpile, which are most common popular sellers that I print over and over and over to keep the stocks up. That's kind of where they're living at for now. I want to incorporate a better solution, a more organized solution, but for now, that surface has surface-itis in the form of 3D printed jigs. To the right of the 3D print wall is my metal storage shelf, and this is where all of the new filament and most of the used filament lives. I have boxes up above, and most of them are stored too deep. So if I see one box, I know there's another one behind it, and I just try and organize them by color, by style, and in as organized fashion as possible. One of the biggest things that I do for my customers is offer the ability that if they want to buy a jig, they can pay a little extra fee and get it in pretty much any color they can think of. This inherently leads me to having to store a lot of filament on hand, but that's okay. Giving my customers the added option of customization, whether they have a handful of jigs from another maker and they see mine and they want it to match, or they just have favorite colors, whatever the case may be, I like to give them the option of choice. That also means I have a lot of storage of open rolls of filament. Rather than keeping them out in the open, I purchased a bunch of clear plastic totes, and every time I open up a box of filament, I take the little desiccant pouch that's in that filament and plop it in one of the totes. At this point, it's probably time to clean the totes out. I imagine there's probably 20 packets in every single tote. But that's my down and dirty, simple solution for storing used filament, keeping it in as low a moisture environment as possible, and not having to spend extra money. So far, it's working pretty good. As far as what brand filament I'm using, I purchase all of my filament directly from Bamboo Labs. I know there are a ton of filament manufacturers out there, and some may be great, some may be sketchy, and honestly, I can't say anything to that at this point. I have always been using Bamboo Labs brand filament from the very beginning. It of course gives me fantastic results. I get consistent colors. I don't have a lot of different batch color variations. So for example, if I have a roll of green that's 2 months old and a brand new roll of green rolls in the shop today, the colors so far have been spot on and I don't have any issues with that. That's fantastic. Now again, that's not to say that Bamboo Lab filament is the only and the best thing to use. I know a lot of people use different things, but for me, whenever you incorporate Bamboo Lab's bulk pricing into effect, which is where you order more than so many filament rolls at a time, they give you a really good discount. Honestly, I'm paying less per kilogram of filament for the bamboo stuff than of anything else I can find on Amazon. Again, that is by a bulk purchase, so it may not be applicable to you, but that's what I'm doing and who I use for filament so far. So one of the elephants in the room, because there may be several in here, is the fact of, Sam, you have an X1 carbon, you have the P1S, but then you bought a bunch of A1s. Why did you do that? What was your thinking? Well, if you know the channel or if you listened in the beginning, the X1 carbon was the first printer that I purchased, period. The first, very first one. That is also the top tier model from Bamboo Lab. At that point, I was not really thinking about a print farm setup so much as I was thinking about a 3D printer to incorporate to use with some things in my shop here and there. And at that point, I was like, okay, we're gonna buy once, we're gonna cry once, give me the best because that's the one I want. That's how it rolled. After that one, I reached out to Bamboo Lab and they sent the P1S for me to also use because I want to eventually do a comparison between the X1 carbon, the P1S, and the A1s, so that's why I have those variety. Ultimately, when it boiled down to Sam spending his dollars, after looking at the X1 carbon, the P1S, the P1P, the A1, and the A1 mini, the one that I chose, obviously, is the A1 with the AMS light combo. That's the one that for the filament and use cases that I have for all of my 3D print files or objects that I sell, just made sense, works perfectly, and I have not regretted it at all. Like I said, there is going to be a comparison video coming down the pike later on, so if you have questions or things you want me to test between the three models, definitely let me know. I'll set it aside. I'll keep the notes together so that whenever the time comes to make that video, I can at least give as much value and answer as many questions you may have as possible. With my current setup, I have 8 A1 printers, and 6 of those are set up where the filament, the AMS light, is mounted to the top of the printer. They are a little bit taller, but then 2 of them are set up more classic style. So you may be wondering, Sam, which one's better? Why did you do that? Or why have you not converted all of them? Or what's going on? So basically what I did is I did convert about 3 to begin with, and I had to reconfigure my shelving. Originally, I was working with that shelf over there with the X1 carbon, the P1S, and 3 A1s. To get them all to fit on one shelf, I had to vertically stack, and that works out pretty good. The only drawback is since the ones up top are the vertically stacked, they are not easy for this short guy to reach for reloading filament. That's okay, have no fear, step ladder is here. Over here on print shelf number 2, you'll notice that I have 3 of the A1s with the vertical stack filament setup, but they are lower. That is perfect. They are easy to reach. I don't need a step ladder for those. But then the other 2 that are up higher, they are still in the default configuration, and that is because it's just easier to change out spools. And right now, I don't need to add another printer to that shelf, and it's okay for them to be a little more take up space width-wise than need to be vertically stacked and everything else. As this print farm grows, things will change. Things will absolutely change. And the benefit of this is I can move the shelves around, I can move the shelving itself around, and change the printer configurations pretty easily. One of the things I love about the A1 printer is that with its touchscreen and its print cache and memory, I can easily pull a plate off, load up an empty one, and from the machine, never going to my computer, tap, scroll through, and pick my next file to print and print it from here. I don't have to go back and forth, I don't have to load files, and that is a huge time saver. It really makes it easy to manage print jobs, especially when dealing with my small print farm that I have set up. I can just beep, bop, beep, bop, beep, boop, boop, load, unload, and keep things going, which is super good for efficiency. Here and there on the shelves, you're gonna notice there are some pieces of paper, and they're turned around backwards because I don't wanna show you customer order printouts, but this is how I manage and handle what printer's running what, where are my customer orders at. It's just some basic magnetic clipboard things. I forget what these are called exactly, but those guys, that right there. And since I have metal shelves, it's super easy just to clip right on there. So that's my solution for order management, I guess you could call it, or just how I work through what printer's doing what, especially as I have multiple orders flowing in and out, moving around the shop. And it's a solution that I thought was kind of cool that I wanted to share with you as well, that honestly has worked out great for me. Well guys, that's gonna be it for the tour of my miniature print farm setup. I say a miniature because, my goodness, there are some really large print farms out there, and by comparison, mine is miniature. But hey, that's just where it is for now. I know in the future it's going to grow, and that's gonna be a whole hurdle in and of itself to figure out what happens in the rest of the workshop space when that does happen. But hey, for now, we can call it my mini farm. If you guys got any questions or comments about the build, the things I've used, how I have things set up, any kind of questions at all, feel free to leave me a comment down below. Also, if you have questions about business aspects, so 3D printing, small business in general, marketing, what to sell, all that kind of stuff, definitely leave me a comment down below on that as well, and I'll try my best to put that in some content coming up. My goal with this channel is not just to stand here and say, look what I've got, this is so great, but not give you the tools to help you also do that for yourself. The motto for Samcraft, or the little tagline that I've got, is helping small businesses since 2018, and that's what I want to do. I'm not here just to show and not tell. I'm here to show and tell. That being said, leave me a comment down below. Thanks for watching as always, and take care. I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.